Going to do linear interpolation in this video. So I have written down the interpolation formula over here, the linear interpolation formula. I'll just show you all through a graph as to what a linear interpolation is. Suppose I have values x1, x2 and y1 and y2. There is a missing value of y which I want to get. So how I can get y? I can get y using all these other values which I have. Using the formula which is there over here. Now y1 is the lower y which is in corresponding to the x1. So I'll give you a small example over here. I have taken three different interest rates and for that I have three different premium values. So for 6% the premium value is 30,000. For 8% it is 24,787. But suppose my interest rate is 7%. In that case, what will be my premium? That is not calculated and that is what I need to calculate using linear interpolation. So it's very simple. We consider that the increase is linear, and then what we do is we take the x1 and the x2 values and the corresponding y1 and the y2 values. We start from y1 and then we multiply the difference between x and x1 with the slope of the line. So this what you see over here is the slope of the line y2 minus y1, x2 minus x1, and we multiply it with the difference of x and the x1. So these values, this is x1 which is the lower x, this is x2 which is the upper x, and correspondingly we have y1 lower y and the upper y which is y2, and we'll then calculate using this formula the y value, which is the premium value for the interest rate 7%. So let us begin. We'll start with y1. This is the y1 or the lower y, plus then we need the x minus x1, which is x minus x1, the lower x. So we'll do x minus x1 multiplied by the slope. The slope is upper y or the y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1. This is the entire formula for a linear interpolation, and when I just click on enter, I get the answer as 27393.5, which is the premium that will be charged for interest rate 7%. So I had all other these values, and how to get the final value using linear interpolation using this formula. Very simple. You just need to put in all the values, which is y1, start from the y1, plus x minus x1 multiplied by with the slope, which is y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1. So this is the entire formula for the linear interpolation. Now what if you do not want to type this formula again and again, and you want to create a table wherein you can just change the x values and you can get the premium? That can also be done, suppose for but that has to be between 6% and 8%. So this whatever x value you put in over here has to be within the 6% and 8%. So let me just make it 6.5 and see. So if I just change it to 6.5, let me increase the 6.5, we get the answer, we get the premium as 28696. So this is how you can just simply change the values of x over here. Let me make it 7.5 and you'll get the answer for your premium, and how this is how it works. The next way, this was the easiest way. This is basic formula which I have done. Suppose you have your entire table of x and y, and then you need to calculate for any specific value of x, you need to calculate a specific value of y. So for that, what are the five things which we need? We need x, we need lower x, which is x1, upper x, which is x2, we need lower y, which is y1, and upper y, which is y2. So these are the values which we require, and then we can simply calculate y using this formula given. So I've taken a normal table over here, as you can see, and I want to calculate the value, y value for 1.5 will lie between 1 and 2, and so I'll get a value of y which will be between 1 and 4. But how to get these values separately over here? As suppose I want in x lower I want 1, x upper I want 2, here I want again want 1, and here I want 4. So this is how, and then I'll use these values to just simply calculate y. So we'll use three functions over here. VLOOKUP, INDEX and MATCH. It's very simple. First of all, I want the x lower value. For that, I'll use a simple VLOOKUP. And the lookup value is 1.5. The entire table array is this table which you require. Then the column index which I from where I need to extract my values is the first column. So I simply type in 1. And then if I type approximate, if I type maybe false for the exact match and let us see what happens, I'll get a NA value because there is no exact match for 1.5 found. So hence I'm getting an error. But I need a simple approximate match. So I'll click on true and I get the answer as 1. So even if it is 1.7, I will get the answer as 1. If it is 4.3, I will get the answer as 4. So basically it will take the lower value, whatever be it. If it is 4.9, still it will take because the exact, because it will only look for the approximate match. It will see 4, it will see 4 over here and it will return me 4. So this is how it will just see the approximate match and not the exact match. And this is my function which I have written. The same function I can type it down for the y lower. Instead of first column, I will extract the values from the second column. So let me just copy the formula, paste it over here. And instead, I will... Okay, so in here, you can make this entire as your F4 absolute because the table will not change, right? The table will not change. And also this value, the lookup value will not change. So I need to make it F4. And I need to make it absolute. So I've made the lookup value absolute because this x value will not change. And I've made the table absolute because this table will also not change. So now let me just copy and paste it over here. And instead from the first column, I want to get the y value, y lower or the y1 value from the second column. So I get the value as 16. For 4.9, I get the x value as 4 and the y value as 16. But now I want the x upper or the x2 and the y upper or the y2 values. How to get these values? It's very simple. Again, we'll use the index and match function. What is a match function? So I'll just give you a small gist of it. Now in the match function, if I take this as my lookup value and I take this as my array and I give the match type as maybe exact match, so let me just keep it as 0. So I get 5. Now what is this 5 over here? If you count this, if you count this entire column, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, so this is the fifth value. 16 is the fifth value in this entire column. 16 again is the fifth value in this entire column, and hence you are getting a 5 as your answer in case of match function. So suppose instead of this, again let me just make this absolute, or let me just leave it like that. So what I'm getting over here is the exact match, which is 5, because over here in this entire column, 5 is the cell or the row number in which you'll find 16. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. 16 is the value which is there in the fifth row in this entire column. Now suppose I just change it to 1.2 again. This also changes to 1. This also changes to 1, y lower. And also the y upper is now 2, because in this entire column, 1 is in the second row, right? So now what actually I want over here is not this value, but I want the y upper or the fourth value. Now I'll just show you all how to use index function. What happens in case of an index function is that when you just give a simple array and you give the row number which you want to extract, suppose I give the row number as 3, 1, 2 and 3, I give the row number, close the bracket, and you get the answer as, so I just wrote 2 over here, 3, and you get the answer as 4. So in this entire array, J3 to J8, I want to extract the number which is there in the third row, which is this row, and I get the answer as 4. So basically from the match function, you get the row number. and from the index function you get the whatever the value is there in that row number. So in here, try to understand, in this y upper I'm getting 2 meaning, 2 meaning this 1 is in the second row, but what I want actually is the value in the third row. So what I'll do is I simply add a 1 to it and I will paste it in my index function. So let me just do it here. I will write an index function, index, and my entire row will be this row which I'll select, and then my row number will be this match. This will give me 2. If you all remember, this answer gave me 2. Why? Because it took this as the lookup value, this as the lookup value, this entire array, and then it gave me 2 as a second row number, but I want the value from the third row number. So what I'll do is I'll just simply add a 1 to it, close the bracket, and I'll get an answer of 4. So this is how you get the answer. Similarly, I'll do it for x upper. I'll show you all again. Suppose I start with writing match, and this is my the lookup array, and obviously again I'll get an exact match. So what will my answer be? My answer will be 2, because this 1 is present in the second row of this entire column. So my answer is 2. But what I actually want is I want this number 2. I do not want the column number, but I want this 2. So what I'll do, I'll write over here index, select this entire column again, and then add a 1 to it, because I do not want the column number or the row number for this. I want whatever the value is below 1, which is 2. So I add a 1 to it and then I get my answer as 2. So this is how, let me just again change it to 3.5. If I change it to 3.5, my x lower and y lower, you can see 3 and 9, and my y upper is second number, which is next, 16, and 4, which is next, which is 4. So this is how you get your entire sets of value. Now you can just simply put in your formula, which is y lower or y1 plus difference between x and x minus 1, x minus x1, which is x lower, multiplied by the slope, which is y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1. So this is how you just simply write it down, write your interpolation formula, and you get the answer as 12.5. using all the values. Now you can just simply change the values over here. I can make it 4.9 and I get my answer, or you can make it 3.5 and you get your answer. So this is how, by using three formulas, VLOOKUP, index, and match, I've created a small table using which whenever you change the x value, which should always be within the range of 1 and 5, will give you the answer of y value. And also you saw this simple approach where you just simply put in your linear interpolation function and you get your answer. Thank you.